So, what does that have to do with rubella and depression? Well, it comes down to risk to benefit ratio. They're basically beginning to tighten the waiver exemptions for people to be exempt from taking vaccines. So it's only right that people know what all the side effects of these vaccines can possibly be. And we're only going to discuss one of the side effects to the rubella vaccine called depression. Now, an interesting aspect of this is researchers actually used the rubella vaccine itself to basically cause depression and behavioral problems in young teenage girls. Now, a study done in 1998 entitled, which is often referenced a lot when it comes to cytokines and depression. Back up. Cytokines, give you an idea. Cytokines are basically something the body produces simply in response to infection. So they believe cytokines, when they become elevated in response to infection, whether it be from lupus, rubella, or whatever it is, can cause depression. So scientists at that time took the best thing they could find out to cause depression, which was the live rubella vaccine, the same one you get injected with today. In the study titled Influence of Socioeconomic Status on Behavioral, Emotional, and Cognitive Effects of Rubella Vaccination, a Prospective Double-Blind Study. What they said in the abstract was simply this. Various medical conditions that involve activation of the immune system are associated with psychological and neuroendocrine changes that resemble characteristics of depression. In this review, we represent our recent study designed to investigate the relationship between the behavioral effects of immune activation and depressive symptomology. In the first set of experiments, now here we go, we used a double-blind prospective design to investigate the psychological consequence of illness in two models. One, vaccination of teenage girls with live attenuated rubella virus, and two, lipopolysaccharides administration in healthy male volunteers. In the rubella study, ready for this, we demonstrated that compared to control group subjects and to their own baseline, a subgroup of vulnerable individuals, girls from low socioeconomic status, otherwise they usually recognize the term as SES, showed a significant virus-induced increased depressed mood up to 10 weeks after vaccination. And this is where I'll basically show you two charts. The first chart showing you basically what's called the child depressive inventory. Look at the graph and see how it moves. Look at the depression rate, and you look at the emotional depression rate itself. Those are pretty significant figures. Now the irony about this, they stopped it after 10 weeks because the immune antibodies basically returned to normal. But if you look at the graph itself, depression was still pretty evident at the 10-week part, regardless of the immune systems returning back to normal. Second graph you want to see, and this is where it becomes amazing. Look at that graph as I read you another abstract from the study. 240 female teenage girls were vaccinated with rubella vaccine. So basically, this is what they came up with. Subjects within the experimental group showed a significant increase in the severity of depressed mood, social and attention problems, and delinquent behavior. A vaccine inducing delinquent behavior in a child? Yes. 10 weeks post-vaccination, there were no difference between the experimental and control groups in serum levels of interleukin-1, beta, interferon gamma, soluble interferon-2 receptors, and cortisol. However, a significant negative correlation was found between fatigue-related symptoms and SIR2 levels in the experimental model, but not the control group. Now, that's the weird part about it. Even though they were vaccinated and they suffered from depression and mood and behavioral problems and attention issues, they were still fatigued after the 10-week part. So, when the question is asked, can a vaccine actually alter or change behavior? According to studies, that's an unequivocal yes, it can. It can incite depression, it can incite attention problems, and it also can incite other behavioral issues altogether. So it's something really to think about when basically vaccinating. So if you vaccinate a child with rubella, yes, your rubella vaccine, the German measles, the three-day measles, may save untold number of lives. But if your child is acting differently, or an individual or adult is acting differently after being vaccinated, keep in mind, it could be the rubella vaccine and not your natural child's behavior. Ralph Church Channel, signing off.